De regreso aquí en Auto 060, y bueno, estuvimos ahí en la experiencia en Willow Springs con el The Best of AMG, and now we're going to switch to English because we're going to talk to Michael Harley, one of the most important journalists on the West Coast, and actually on the country, because he's on the web, autoblog.com, to talk about his opinion, his impression of this AMG, Best of AMG experience at the Willow Springs in California.
Well, Michael, thank you very much for taking the time out of the track, because I know you love doing that. You were here at Willow Springs driving all the AMG products. And, like, since you have driven pretty much everything this year, since I follow you closely, what's your opinion of this car?
First and foremost, if you looked at the big track cars, those were the SLS Black Series cars. I was probably most impressed the fact that the SLS Black is such a jump above the standard SLS. You know, the standard SLS has got a hard ride. It's a super fast car. You know, some people would call it, you know, it's an exotic. It's a supercar. But the Black Series is such an improvement in performance-wise. You know, you've got a wider track front and rear. The whole front clip is brand new. You've got new bodywork. You've got new aerodynamics, new suspension tuning. And the transmission's been upgraded. And it's such a step up. And a lot of times automakers come out with performance packages where they say, you know, we've done this. We're going to call them S model.
Mainly cosmetics sometimes.
Yeah, they're almost all cosmetics. And maybe you say, okay, you know, you and I get behind the wheel and go, okay, you know, nobody would ever notice the difference. But the Black Series is such a changeover. It's night and day. You could blindfold someone in the passenger seat, and you know, they think there were two different cars. I was able to go in the standard SLS after spending all day lapping the Black, and it felt like I had a plush ride, which is something you'd never ever say.
Yeah, so it's pretty amazing how that technology, I mean, the hard work of the engineer, and like, they have these modes to drive, and then you press a button, it changes everything, right?
Yeah, the car completely transforms itself, and part of the fun was getting in the car and switching, you know, three or four different transmission shift modes. You had the multi-level suspension settings, and on this track, this is a bumpy track. We're out at the big track at Willow, and it's got some serious dips, and when you're doing 100 to 140 miles an hour, you don't want to be hitting these bumps hard and launching wheels into the air. So it was nice to be able to adjust the suspension where it was compliant enough to actually swallow the impacts and keep the car on the road.
And actually makes like a bad driver like me a little bit better.
We're all bad drivers compared to the pros they had.
Exactly. I mean, I just drove with Matias Maris, the CEO of AMG, and it's amazing like how he can really push the car.
Yeah, he took me out for some hot laps yesterday, and he kept chuckling. We'd be going into the corners, and I think we're going to die. And I'd look up, and I'd see the walls coming, and he'd laugh and say, "It's my baby," and get on the gas, and we'd just shoot off to the next corner. I mean, he knows those things, you know, like the back of his hand.
He makes them, so he better knows them, right?
A lot of fun.
So, Michael, as I was saying, I mean, I follow you, and, like, you drive every single car that I have there.
Been lucky.
Yeah, exactly. So how do you compare this car with others that you have driven this year? You've been in the Lamborghinis, you've been in the new Porsche, everything, the top cars.
You come into these events with expectations. You think certain cars are going to perform certain ways, and most of the time they generally do exactly what you think they're going to do. The car at today's AMG event that most blew my mind would probably be the Wagon.
Yeah, me too.
Of all the things, it was, you know, the name is just stupendously long. It's the AMG, you know, E63S AMG 4MATIC Wagon.
Exactly.
But what it really means is it goes really, really fast with, you know, as many people as you want. And the nice thing is, you know, it's got 577 horsepower. And in the old days, you know, with 577 horsepower in a rear-wheel drive car, you got a ton of oversteer. And this thing just launches, and all you get is wheel spin. But the nice thing about the Wagon is you've got 4MATIC. You have the extra 200 pounds because of the extra, you know, body shell on the back wheels, which actually balances the car out. And I've said over and over again, with the 4MATIC, it reduces the understeer, and it reduces the oversteer at the same time. Reduces the understeer because when you go into these corners, you can apply a little power, shift the weight backwards evenly, and it reduces the oversteer when you come out of the corners because you get on the gas and the front wheels are pulling you around. I mean, they're splitting the torque, I think 33 in the front and 67 in the back, but it's a really, really balanced, and that car flies. I mean, 0 to 16 in 3.5 seconds.
Yeah, you're driving it, and then you forget how much car you have, you have behind you, right?
You look in the rearview mirror, and all of a sudden you go, oh my gosh, I'm driving a Wagon.
Exactly.
And what's even more exciting is being in the Wagon or being in another car following the Wagon, and you're flying down these, you know, down the straights, you toss the car in the corner, and you look up, and there's a station wagon in front of you, and you can't catch it.
Exactly. It's amazing. It's an amazing vehicle.
That's a lot of fun.
So where can our audience can follow you? You have autoblog.com, obviously, but like, tell us more about
autoblog.com, and we're trying to do more and more track stuff this year. We've covered a lot of fun stuff. Upcoming stories, got some Aston Martin stories coming. Hopefully get a spin of the 918 Spider, Porsche's upcoming hybrid. And hopefully next year I get a spin of the P1.
But, nice, the McLaren.
So we'll see. But trying to do some things that are fun and exciting. And the nice thing, you know, these are all supercars, but the most enjoyable part is you're tasting the technology that's going to trickle down into almost all the consumer part, you know, consumer cars in the near future. Like you said, the multi-mode transmission, the multi-mode suspensions, the transmissions and things like that, that stuff eventually trickles down. Years ago, only the race cars had the dual-clutch transmission.
Exactly, yeah.
And now everybody's getting a dual-clutch. And so these supercars that we're seeing, the lightweight carbon fiber, the active aerodynamics, you know, these are cars that people are going to be driving 10 to 15 years from now. It's going to be standard equipment.
Exactly. And pretty exciting for us to be doing it right here, right?
Right. So,
thank you very much again
for
your time, Michael. And again, I'll keep following you on autoblog.com.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
Los espero en la próxima edición de Auto 060 aquí en Cristina Radio Network.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.